Hi everyone, Amber here. I am the owner and head trainer at Summit Dog Training. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to set up one of the foundational pieces of Acuity Scheduling software in order to harness the power of the software for your pet business, whatever that is, dog training, pet boarding, grooming, everything within our industry. I've been using Acuity for my dog training business for almost 5 years now, and I love how it has helped us build efficiency and allow us to expand and grow with minimal headaches and minimal effort as we've grown as a company. When I first started using Acuity, I was just using one calendar, which is what I'm going to show you how to set up today. Now, with a team of trainers and a facility where we rent out space outside of class time as well, we use many more calendars to help us keep track of everything, and Acuity has been able to support us through that growth. Now, this might seem like a really simple step, but Acuity has built some very interesting and nuanced features into their calendar settings. And so we're going to touch on those and explore those today so that you can get the most out of your Acuity software right from the start. Don't forget to click subscribe below so that you can catch our new videos on Acuity and other dog topics every week. Okay, so let's dive into setting up and optimizing your first calendar with Acuity. Step one is you're going to go to the availability tab on the left side of your Acuity dashboard. And if you haven't already set up yourself with an Acuity dashboard, you can do that. There's a link below in the description of this video. It's free to get started. You just need to enter a little bit of information and then you'll be ready to go. So you'll go to the availability on the left-hand side of the page and you're going to click add new calendar. Step two, enter your calendar details. The name could be your name or the name of a location, like north location or south location if you have multiple spots where you teach, depending on what you are using your calendar for. At Summit, we give each instructor their own calendar so that clients can schedule with them directly, with each instructor directly, and it helps them keep track of what appointments are on their calendar. Moving on, let's talk about some of the other settings that we have available for us on the Add Calendar page. If you have a calendar where all services on that calendar are held at the same location, you can enter the address here so that this shows up on your client email forms. If you have a calendar that handles appointments that move to different locations, I recommend keeping this location section blank so as to not confuse your clients. You have the option to add a longer description on each calendar. This can be a great place to put notices to your clients about what they can schedule on this calendar or what the expertise of the person that they're scheduling with might be. For example, the Summit team uses this section to put a little bit of information about what each instructor specializes in. One instructor specializes in agility, the other in behavior problems, the other in puppy challenges. And so we put a little bit of a bio, short bio there so that a client that is trying to decide who they are going to schedule with can have that information right at their fingertips. Lastly, you'll want to put the email address you want calendar scheduling notices to be sent to, as well as make sure that the email address for client replies is correct as well. The main email address that is part of your Acuity account will be sent every single scheduling notice that comes through your scheduling software. But if you want your individual instructors to get emails when things are scheduled on their calendars as well, you can put their email addresses here too. If you want client replies to go to a particular destination, for example, go to the instructor whose calendar they're scheduled on, you also want to make sure that the setting for replies from this calendar go to, here found here at the bottom of the page, is linked to the correct email address that you are wanting to send people to. Step three, select the appointment types that can be scheduled on that particular calendar. If you have an instructor who only offers a certain type of appointments, you can limit the permissions on that calendar to only allow those appointment types to be scheduled, which is a pretty neat feature. So you'll want to go through your first calendar and any subsequent calendars and make sure that the appointments that you want scheduled there are the ones that have the permissions to be scheduled there and so on. Step four, set up availability for your appointments. We'll take a closer look at availability settings in a different video, but for now, just set up some basic parameters. If you don't want your client scheduling before 6 a.m. or after 9 p.m., those are good parameters to build into your calendar. What are some of your preferred hours to book client services? Are you a night owl or an early bird? Comment below. Tell us which you prefer so we can have a little of dialogue about what times we all prefer serving our clients. All right, moving on. Step five, set up the client scheduling limits. These are very important as they help determine when your clients are able to schedule or can schedule and reschedule their appointments and how many appointments you take on a particular calendar at once. These will be your default settings for the whole calendar, but they can be customized further to allow for different permissions for different service types. For example, at Summit, we allow students to register for a group class up to 2 hours before the class starts, but we restrict private lesson enrollments to more than 24 hours prior to the appointment time. That way we're not getting any last minute private lessons that we weren't aware of it with enough notice. We'll go into this feature further in a separate video on availability settings. And then you're done. That's how you get your first calendar up and running in Acuity, and you are ready to go. We will continue to tweak some of these settings to get it fully optimized for you. So make sure you check out the next video in this series to continue working to make sure that everything is set up in Acuity to optimize your success. To learn more about setting up Acuity for your pet business, you can grab my free 10-part checklist specifically for pet pros. I go into the top 10 steps for setting up Acuity for your success and quickly building efficiency and customer experience into your pet business. Click the link below to grab that guide. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up and check out some of the other videos on our channel. See you next time.